Buckfever Underground has got about three core values. In order to be a band, you need a band name. It's one. In order to be a band, you need to eventually play live. And in order to be in a band, you need to have fun. And none of those three include working out what we're going to do or rehearsing. And that's why some of our songs are so damn catchy, like this one. The song is about all of you guys. It's called The South African, except the Namibian, of course. It's not about you, I'm afraid. But if you stay for long enough and marry a local lady, you know, we can organize stuff for you. The South African is walking through the waterfront, dressed like a monk, hands free of parcels or wallet, flowing purplish brown hues, robe and a smile, slightly self-conscious. Like he wasn't expecting all these people to be out shopping on a Sunday. The South African is sitting with others at the German beer place, with the South African back briefly from Ireland, and the South African on his way to London, first time. The South African is in the third pew, and she makes a movement with her hair, which stirs the entire church. It seems like her whole body is rising, but it remains seated. Outside, Maitland is a nervous grey film of the quietly dead, the soil-bound, the motor car hewn landscape, three breakdowns on the way. The South African says she'll leave the country if Zuma becomes president. The driver argues with her. They drive up Voortrekker Road. What are those? Are those people? Asks the South African, approaching the cemetery, not wearing her glasses. Yes, says the driver, those are people. The South African is leaving a flat, dressed in tracksuit pants and t-shirt, touching the brick wall of the third floor with a one hand. Security gate ajar, she walks down the steps, disappears, reappears at the bottom, and she starts jogging. The South African is walking back from the spa at sunset in autumn. The day an old girlfriend's freckled cheek, 100 meters in front of him, a man runs into view from a side street, chased by another. The one is a thief, the other is slower. The South African is in court, who shot his two children with an assault rifle. Tried to kill himself, wife too. They survived. The South African receives an SMS. I'm at Jay-Z party in Lani, Durban. Hardcore. The South African got the call, standing by the window, cold tears funneled from clouds. Outside, it rained. The South African can win. One gas stove daily for a week. The South African Egyptian geese are sitting on the corner of a Jewish girls' school, bricklaying their call over the sun-slash-city bowl below. Then, they pick up their wings and plunge with heavy lungs from the artificial cliff into a valley moist with people. The South African eats Japanese, the South African eats Italian. He flips an egg in a pan, he breaks open an orange, dreams of primary school. The South African is on the radio, he's inside his voice, he's jamming in a band. The South African has finished his beer, he gets up for another. The South African is boarding a plane, he's going to Dakar and will drive to Bamako and then Timbuktu, and he will learn bits and pieces of Wolofon French now to take off his hat to expose his exploding soft walnut brain. The South African is buying books to fill holes with. Shop assistants in windows today were draping gold around plastic necks, dressing half a mannequin dead on the floor. The South African was in a car with a German from Germany, stuck in a crowd of thousands of protesting security guards, who then turned into looters and bumped a Filipino man, 77, through a pharmacy window. The South African turns the page and reads an infographic about a new dance craze in the bird flu hit Ivory Coast, which mimics the final stutters of a dying chicken. get a drink. We'll be back in 20 minutes or half an hour or so. Thank you.